This is a very nice 3D printed clock that I found on the internet. And if you want a clock like this, you really can't buy one. You have to make it yourself. The people that design these projects make the STL files available for free. And all you need is a 3D printer and the desire to make one. This photo shows the 51 pieces that are required to make this clock. And my hat is off to the person who designed this. This contains some really high quality part design. This goes together very, very well. This will be 6 inches high and about 16 inches long when it's all put together. This has the diffusers in the front. These are printed as individual pieces, and the design of this is very nice. It has these prism-like sections in here to help diffuse the light. You put in the 7 sections. I want to make sure that they are all the way down, which generally is not a problem. After you get these pieces in here, it rattles a little bit. And there's a tab that sticks out here, here, and here. This is the cover. This is the frame. This is the front of the frame. When we put this together, it'll be down. And it has a corresponding indent here, here, and here. So this is the correct way to put it together. This is the incorrect way. And when you put this on here, it still kind of rattles. When it snaps down, there's no rattle at all to it, really. It's a very firm assembly. It's very nice. The next one, you do exactly the same thing. Put the 7 pieces in. Verify where those 3 tabs are and verify the tab positions are here. And it snaps together. And that's it. As far as I can tell, no glue is required. And when it's together, your clock will look like that. We turn these over. Get ready to string the LEDs through here. It starts here, and the track goes up and over. And the LEDs come around and through here on the inside, come across here to here, go up and over, come back and down through here. Over the top on this one, continue over to here, and work your way back until you have a final LED in this section, and you stop here. So you start, wind through here, wind back, and you stop. And I believe it's a total of 252 LEDs. There will be essentially an LED in each of these pockets. And when you're done, the cover plates snap on here. Then there's an electrical box that goes on here. and your clock module and your Arduino Nano will fit in here. Then you can either put 2 feet on it, or you can put a hanger. You can hang it on a nail. And if you so desire, you can make one more of these sections that goes here in the middle, and it will be hours, minutes, seconds. I'm just doing hours and minutes. These small LEDs are on one continuous strip, and there are 60 per meter. These are made up of 500 millimeter lengths, so there's a solder joint every half meter. I purchased a spool which was 5 meters long, so there are 10 strips joined together, and it takes a little over 4 meters to complete this clock. A lot of planning went into the design of this clock, and if you take your string of LEDs and you cut off this first LED, then as you install these LEDs and you're bending them back and forth through the different segments, when you come to a solder joint, you will not have to bend it at that point. There are 2 sides to these LEDs. You got the 5 volt and the ground, but this side is signal in and this side is signal out. We're actually going to induce power on this end of the strip. We're going to connect plus and minus here, and it will feed power the full length of this strip, about 4.5 meters, 4 1/3. And then a plus and a minus will come from here. It will go to the Arduino Nano and the real-time clock. And then the signal wire from the Nano comes back to this side, and it goes to DI, or signal, or digital in, and feeds the signal down the line of LEDs. Each one of these LEDs has its own microprocessor built in here. And so the signal is designed such that that microprocessor can determine whether it's supposed to turn on or off or change color or whatever. These LEDs operate on 5 volts, and I'm running the clock with a wall charger. This is a little bigger than usual. This is 2 amps. Connecting these to a DC power source will not turn these on. This is connected to a remote controller, but my remote's not working, so it is only displaying this combination of colors. And if we had a way of sending different signals down here, we'd be able to get this to flash in different colors and everything. The LEDs start at this point. This is where you cut the first LED off, and you wrap it around through this maze. He has very good instructions on his construction article. And you continue until you get back to this point. I've marked each one of the solder joints with a piece of blue tape, and you can see where they're located. You don't have to bend that strip. It just clears. So there's 8 solder joints to this point. That's 240 LEDs plus another 12 to get to here. That's 252. Now this is the end of the string. So power, this red and black, that puts your DC voltage to the end of the string, and it comes back to the beginning here, and the red and black go to the Arduino Nano, and this green wire is the signal from the Nano. And then you have to carefully feed the wires up through this first cover. This is the electric junction box, and there are 8 screws in this plus a couple of more out here. I get this all squared up, and I tighten these 2 screws on the colon first. These have all been snugged up and then backed off about a half a turn. So when I get this all lined up on a good straight edge, tighten a few of them, double check it for straight, pick it up and make sure your joints here are nice. And I have the bases on the real-time clock and on the Nano. I'll organize these wires and then put the lid on there. Everything's tidied up in there. And he has a rear cover plate that has this little hanger built into it. This piece, you have to push down on that and slide it all the way over to here. And then when this is tightened on there, that pushes down. There's a little detent in there that keeps this from coming off. And then I use a couple of what I call fish eyes, little dots of silicone. When the clock is on the wall and leveled, they help keep it from moving around. You want to tighten these up, make them snug, but don't get too carried away. It is a piece of printed plastic. I've had this thing apart and together several times, playing with color changes and changing the display. I have it set up to display 24 hours. I have the flashing colon turned off. It's on solid. 24-hour clock, you do not need AM or PM indication. And I have it in one solid color. Anytime you go to build one of these projects, you're taking a little bit of a chance because you're not sure, is it really going to go together for me as easily as it appears in the article? This does. This is one of the best 3D printing projects I have run into. A thumbnail to Daniel's channel page will be at the end of this video. He has several other clock designs as well. Links to the Instructables construction article and to the Thingiverse page will be in the description for this video.